Hello everyone, my name is Saokosal. This is part 3 of the navigation driver in Android Studio. You can watch the previous video, part 1 and part 2, at my channel. You can contact me on Facebook, Kasolgi, or Twitter, or you can download some source code at GitHub as well. In the first video, I talk about the basic navigation driver, the basic UI, and the fragment. Part 2, I talk about the view and how to add the views on the fragment, event handler and list on the fragment. In this video, I will talk about how to change the navigation driver from the left to right and add some animation. Okay, this is the example from the previous video. We already made a menu for that and add some item on this and list view. Okay, now we want to change the position. Okay, so what we have to do, first you go to the activity main here, and here you change from start to end, and layout gravity to end as well. And if you want a size maybe a little bit smaller, you can change the width, maybe 200 dp. Okay, and then you go to main activity. And here, what you have to change is here, you want to change to N as well. And this one is very important when you want to prevent the user from, let's say you press back while you are here. When you press back this, usually the back acts like the exit button. Okay, so in here on back press, it prevents the code from exit the application when you are in the open the navigation driver. Okay, so now we want to change from the start to end, and then here the last part of the on navigation item selected. Here you want to change to end as well. This one happen when, let's say, you are in fragment. Let's say now you are in one particular fragment, and when you click on another fragment, another menu, then the navigation driver will close. Okay, so now we change to end as well. And what else here in the application? Let me run it. You don't have the menu, the hamburger menu on the right side. Instead, you have to use the menu here, the setting here to be the hamburger menu. So what you have to do, you go to main menu here, and maybe I want to change to menu right. And this one, let me zoom a little bit. When you say never, it's gonna hide inside the three dots menu, and if you say always, then it will show. Okay, but now you want to change to the icon, and for the icon, maybe you can find a good one from the internet, a similar one to the hamburger menu. But for me, I just use this one that I just downloaded. Copy and paste to the drawable menu here. Okay, yes, now I can call it drawable and then user. Okay, so suppose it is the one that you want to add a user. Okay, you can have other item as well. Okay, maybe let's say search. Okay, this one is 100, this one just say 1. Okay, this is another one, and this one I want to use the one from Android. Just search. Okay, this is just an example. Okay, nothing special, but the one that we want to use is the menu right. Okay, so you go back to the main activity here, and in here the on options item selected here. Now we change to menu right. What you have to do is to call the drawer, but we don't have the drawer because the drawer is inside the onCreate. So now just copy to outside and delete this one like this. Now you are free to use it in another method as well. So drawer is, you say if drawer is drawer open, okay, and now open from where? From the right or from the left? Now you say gravity and from the right, right? If the drawer is open from the right, then you close it. Okay, so for close drawer gravity right, else then you open it. Okay, so this is the most important part. You want the menu acts like the hamburger menu instead. So run it. Click on this. You can see now the menu is from the right. Okay, and this one is no longer used. So you want to disable this button. What you have to do, you go to Tackle and you say Tackle. Set drawer indicator enable, and you set to false, then there is no hamburger menu. Okay, now no hamburger menu. Now the menu is from the right, and when you click on the back, now it acts like the usual. Click on this, okay, this again. Okay. So the last part of this is the animation. But before the animation, I want to point out something. Maybe you notice it or not, but when you first start it, you don't see anything, just a blank one. Actually, it's not good. You want to have one fragment as the default one. So maybe you want to choose the first one. Okay, so to do that is very easy. You go to the code for the fragment here, just copy and then press in the onCreate method, and maybe at the last part of this. Now you have the default fragment, and when you click on another one, just like okay, but the animation for this is just a very basic one. So now we're gonna move to the animation. The animation for the transaction is very simple. What you have to do first, you go to the rest and new directory, and you can call anim, and you can call the folder name whatever you want. And I have my own animation. This one is for the slide in from left and slide out from left. So what you have to do is to change maybe the duration, and the X now is minus 100%, okay, and to X 0%, okay, and then you want to move out and from 0 to 100, okay, and this is for the offset. The from X delta is offset. This is a simple animation. If you want like fading, you may find some more useful information from Google. But it's just a basic one, and you can just change it easily. Here, the manager, okay, around here. You go down and you say set custom animations. Okay, you need two parameters. First one is the enter, as you can see, and the exit. So the enter is slide in and the exit is slide out. So we call by all dot anim dot slide in from left, and you exit all dot anim slide out from left. Okay, and you just copy and paste to the other ones. Saokosal. Okay, see that? Now the animation look better. Okay, that's it for this video. I know there are more to learn about the navigation driver, but I covered all of the basic features of the navigation driver. I hope you like it, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.